Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is data flows in Power BI. So let us walk through this architecture of Power BI services, how this data flow, where this data flow fit in the Power BI services. You can see here, like data flows that will get the data from the data sources and storing the data in Azure Data Lake storage. Then from that data flows, the data sets get the reports and dashboard. So basically, instead of data sets directly getting from the data sources, it can be on-premises or Azure SQL, whatever be your data sources, right? You can store your data in the data lake storage using data flows. That is the basic idea behind data flows. And when to use it and what is the difference between data sets and data flows, we can see it in next video. But in this video, let us try to create one data flow that will take the data from data source and store it here. Let's try to check it in this video as a demo. Now, the prerequisite is like, I have this Power BI free account where when you want to create a workspace, I need a pro account, right? So basically what I'm trying to say is, in my workspace, if you go and click here, the data sets are appearing. You can create the data flows only using this option. This is not comes under your personal workspace, whereas you need to create one dedicated workspace that is used to create reports, and it can be shareable. What I'm trying to say is, you need to have your content workspace where you can create your data flows. But for free user, this is not available. So you need to have a pro user account to create data flows. That is the first rule I want to make. Now I'm an user who is having pro user privileges, and I've created workspace. Basically, last time you see free user, you cannot create. Now you see he's a pro user, you can create. Just give the name, whatever you want. Similarly, I created executive dashboard. Here you can see a data flows. So as the name indicates, it's a ETL tool that is deployed in cloud, prepare, clean and transform, and the data is stored in the Azure Gen 2 storage. Let us try to create one. When you click on it, there are different options, and we will start with the basic. Other things you can explore once you get the idea about data flows. So define new entities, which is nothing but a single table is considered as entity. So as you can see here, the Power Query choose data source. So one thing I want to highlight here, what is this? So when you have a report here, right, this is the typical report that created, we connect to source, can be Excel or database, and we create this report and we will do the modeling before creating the report. And you can see the transform query here, which will connect the data source and we can do the transformation, changing data type, everything, right? So this is specific to the report, and the whatever transformation happened in the Power Query will not be stored anywhere. It is passed to the next stage of this particular report. That is, after doing transformation, immediately data is transferred to the Power Pivot for the modeling and reporting. So this is specific to the report, the Power Query embedded in the Power BI desktop. Whereas here, the Power Query, it is not specific to any reports. It works dedicatedly separated from your reports. Okay, you have some common table, and that transformation is happening frequently in each and every data set. You not avoid that. You can do the transformation once and store it here. Then you can use that particular entity in all the data sets. That is the concept behind data flows. So let us try to create one of the data flows using Excel file. Can paste it here. This is my path. And one more thing I want to highlight here is, this is the on-premise gateway, and this is not use will list out your personal gateways. This is basically a standard gateways that will be you need to use. That is for your information, and you need to provide your username and password. Then click on next. So this Excel, instead of Excel, you can create any source, whether you have Azure account or your SQL Server on-premise, whatever respective gateways you need to connect. So here you can see you can either transform a data, and I can do any processing. You click on transform data. By default, I mean, it is not like load and transform data. You need to do some transformation if it is exist, then only you can save it. Okay, basically you're going for that purpose only. So there is no direct way to load. You go to transform data, and then if there is any data transform, then you do it. I don't want to do anything here. Just I will drop some columns. That's it. So remove columns. You can apply the same Power Query transformations, whatever you can do, because you can see right click and replace column, split column. You can add a column by conditional column. Same Power Query, because as I said, Power Query is deployed in your cloud. That is the thing. So you can do the transformation. I did some transformation, then save and close. That's it. So you can give a name to this data flow. Let us try to give a name. Now this is like a sales table, okay, something like that. Let's keep this one. You can refresh it if you want. So this is basically the table name inside the data flow, whatever entity name. Okay, so entity name, if you want to change it, you might have changed it here in the transform. So that is not the your data flow name. So here you need to change. Let us say sales. Okay, save and close. So the sales table is your data flow. Inside that you have a table called sales. You can name it properly. In that way you can properly manage it. Now this comes over here. You can see here, this is the data flow symbol, and you can see the data flows appear here. And let us try to build some report from this data flows. I'm launching a Power BI desktop. So similarly, you connect to Power BI dataset, you can able to connect to your Power BI data flows as well. That is what I'm going to show it now. So I have an empty file here. Now I can go to Power BI data flows this time. So when you launch it, it will ask for credentials. So when I click on data flows, so you can see here whatever data flows I have access to, those will be listed. In this case, I have only one, so it will be listed now. Now you can see from in which workspace. This is the workspace in that I have only one data flows. That is sales table is my data flow, and inside that what I have this table, I can connect it. So there is no data since I didn't process it. Then let us try to load it and try to create a report. If you want data, just now we can see it, right, how it will reflect here. Let us try to refresh the data flow. So you created the data flow, it is not refreshed yet, right? So there is no data, only you created the metadata. Now that is why in your Power BI file you do not have any data at all. When we refresh here, that will reflect in your Power BI desktop file as well. Try to see it. It is refreshing the data from the data flows, trying to connect to my laptop or wherever your source and get the data, and that will be stored in your Azure data lake, and my Power BI report trying to connect here, then creating a report. That is what we are trying to do here, and check the status. It is still processing. We'll wait for a couple of seconds. It's taking. It's the very first time it's trying to load. Yeah, it is refreshed. Now let us go and connect here and go and refresh. Now you can see it is connecting to data flows and getting the data. Now you can see 541 rows. Now you can see the data here. Now you can build the dashboard as usual, with similar to how you create other reports. It's like let us try to drag and drop some item here, and then we can see what happens. So selling price, or where is that, let us say selling price, and then we can go for sale date, and let us try to visualize it by date. It should be access here. This is perfectly all right. There is no date. Let's try to do something else. There is no data. I think we will see which column has the data. I think item amount, as we are familiar with it. Even I forgot, what is that item amount? Yes, here it is. Values, you need to put it in values. Now you got the data here. Let us try to see it in order type or item type. There is no item type, I think. Order type name. Now you can see, as we know, there is 18 are takeaway. These are the two categories we have. We can publish this report as well. And let's try to publish and see how it looks in Power BI services. I need to save it. So it is sales analysis. So I didn't focus on creating reports. That is not our main objective, as we are already familiar with creating the reports. Just we will see, trying to understand what is data flows, how it looks like. Now let us try to see it here. Refresh it, and you can see the content. There is a data set created with the name the sales analysis and a report as well. The report is nothing but whatever we just now created here, and let us try to see the lineage view of it so that you can understand better. So we have Excel, we have data flow, we have data set and report. Let us try to find the difference between data flows, data set in our next video. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button and share with your friends. Do remember that data is your asset.